hand clapping, rhythmic shaking, and screams of happiness. And in this day, when people are talking about how bad the economy is, this guy is working to capacity. Audiences everywhere. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome a rock and roll institution, Fats Domino. Yeah. Domino. We'll be right back at the station identification. How many, the song you sang, how many million records has that sold, Blueberry Hill?
I would say close to between 11 and 12 million.
Wow. The one record has sold 11 and 12 million?
I just say thanks to the people, too.
Yeah. How many records all told have you sold?
Pretty close to... Well, 65 million, 64, 65.
60, you think it's going to pick up?
65 million, Rick. I'd like to sell 65.
If it don't pick up, Mike, I just say thank God for what didn't happen already.
Oh, he's been good to you, hasn't he?
Wonderful.
Are those real diamonds?
They're supposed to be.
Holy Toledo, there's nothing left. If somebody goes out to buy an engagement ring, the town is empty. Look at this. That says, those are real. It says Fats. Look at this. What is that, a champagne bottle?
Yeah, bottle of champagne.
Is there any significance to any of these? Or did you have that made for a reason, the champagne bottle?
I like champagne, but I didn't quite have it.
Can I show the watch? It's incredible. Look at this.
Well, it's kind of big. Everything comes big in Texas.
Hey, Liberace's the beginner next to you, man. It's unbelievable.
You like diamonds? How many diamonds in the watch?
But 352, I think.
Is that your bank account? You just carry it around with you?
I was 21 years ago when I first started traveling, I had $3,700 in the bank. Didn't know if I was going to make another record when I started in my first room. And I had $3,700 in the bank, and I saw a ring for $3,650. And I wrote out a check for $3,650, and $50 in the bank.
Just had $50 and did you realize at the time, did you feel that you were going to be successful when you wrote out the check for that ring? Or did you care?
Didn't think about it.
What was your first hit record?
The first record I made was 1949.
What was it?
Called A Fat Man.
It was called A Fat Man?
Yeah.
Did you write it?
Yeah.
Did you write the song? How many of your songs have you written? How many of your big hits have you written?
Well, I wrote 16 of myself, sort of a meme.
Oh boy, that's where you really get well.
Yeah, man. Have you co-writer of mine by name of David Fowler, he wrote the other ones.
You live, your home is in New Orleans, isn't it?
Yeah, still
he owns it.
How many children have you, Fats?
Oh, my wife got eight. We got five. Four wonderful boys, four girls.
Four boys and four girls?
Yeah.
Do any of them play instruments? Like
yeah, two of them.
That's nice. Yeah. Somebody told me that you have 10 cars. Why do you have that many cars? You're going to need to drive one at a time, can't you?
Well, if I do, drive one at a time.
What kind of cars are they?
You know, different cars, used Ford, sometimes Lincoln. You know, I usually use Cadillac, but I have a Rolls Royce too.
Do you have a Rolls?
Yeah. Anyway, we just can't drive them one at a time. It's like, yeah.
So, where do you keep them? Do you keep them all in the garage, or do you have to keep some of them outdoors?
Well, four garages, you know.
Four garages.
I'm always keeping them parked in. Do very little, nobody touching.
What is your goal now? I mean, you've...
Well, my goal, I've just been almost reached it, and what I would like to, really like to do is help a lot of people who believe in helping themselves, that who can't. If I can help them a little, I'll be glad to. I'm always willing.
That's wonderful. You know, not long ago in San Diego, we did a show, and I was telling Fats about this upstairs. We were at Cal Western University, and I was introducing another gentleman who was a rock and roll legend. And the whole audience, all the students stood up and gave him a standing ovation when he walked out. I didn't even know because they're so young, how would they know about a Chuck Berry? But he just tore the place down.
We played together.
When you perform too, doesn't it?
Same thing. I guess some of the people, I guess I was just very blessed with everything looked like.
Well, rock and roll is still hanging in there, isn't it? It's as hot as ever.
Yeah, I think it is. Yeah. Seems to be.
What about the new groups around today? Do you have a particular favorite that you...
I like the Beatles very much. Matter of fact, I like all music. But I like the Beatles because they write great songs.
I do like great songs.
Maybe one thing I don't like about the movie too much, you can't exactly hear the words like you would. To me, the verses should be brought out. But there's a lot of great songs, don't get me wrong.
Yeah, but how do you explain that? Because I'm not putting the music down, but when I listen to the top 40 stations, seldom can I make out the lyrics, you know, of what they're saying. And I'm listening, and everybody, it's a hit, and I say, well, I say to my little girl, what are they singing about? And she knows. And her hearing is no better than
mine. Well, maybe because she's younger than you.
You and I are getting along just fine. You had to bring up age.
You know, when I met Fats upstairs, he had a wardrobe hanging up on the wall, and he said, "What do you want me to wear?" And I said, "Anything will make you happy." And he said, and he had a gorgeous gray velvet suit. And I said, "Well, that would kind of blend in with the background."
You know, I told you he had red towels, so I'm gonna wear some kind of red in the room. So I did.
That's great. Who makes your clothes for you?
Well, different people.
You like velvet things and loud things, don't you?
Well,
make you feel
not too loud. Just so
you don't have to see me. You like a red light. Make sure you stop. You
does that make
light.
You feel good to wear a suit like that? That hot red color. Does that make you feel good?
Well,
does it?
Those like when you feel good, it makes you feel hot. It's velvet. It's kind of. I just like to be. I don't know.
You know, you're a very warm and easy human being to talk to.
Well, I think you're feeling my clothes.
Oh, no, you You mentioned earlier, Jerry asked you the first song you recorded, and you said it was Fat Man, which was a composition.
Yeah, it was in 1949, my first record.
Would you like to do a little revival of it
right
here?
Would it be all right if I say hello to my friend, Marty Allen? He been somewhere.
Marty Allen?
Yeah, we worked together.
He was here yesterday.
I spoke to him on the phone.
Yeah.
And we worked together at the Flamingo Hotel.
Oh, he's in the great guy.
Oh, wonderful. Him and his wife were pretty wonderful.
Yeah, they're great people, Marty and Freshie. Okay, you can do the Fat Man for us?
Okay.
That's done.
Don't forget my name.
1949.